Welcome everyone, I'm your host, Elias Serentopoulos. As Vectornado keeps getting new features, let's go ahead and explore the offset tool by an example. Up next. Inside Vectornado with a new document open, I have already created a text layer using a handwritten font from Google Fonts with a playful font style. Now, because I will be working with the offset tool inside Vectornado, I always create a duplicate of the type layer just in case I need to start all over, which means in this case, I would tap on the layers tab here. And with the text layer selected and up in the action bar, I would tap on the copy icon and then tap on the paste icon to create a duplicate. And all I'm going to do here is basically toggle off the visibility of the first layer. Now, looking at the type here, it looks a bit condensed. So I will go ahead and add some space between the characters. And I'm going to do this inside the style inspector by changing and increasing the tracking value from 0 to 10. And then I'm going to tap where it says fit bounds to text. I'm going to go ahead and place this. There we go. And then I'm going to go ahead and tap where it says create outlines from text. That converts the text into shapes, as we can see inside the layers panel. And that gives us the flexibility to control each of the shapes separately. So now we are ready to actually use the offset tool, which means I'm going to tap on the path inspector, and all the way at the bottom, I'm going to tap on the offset path. The offset tool creates a duplicate of the original shape at a different scale value. It is a replica shape that is evenly distanced from the center of the original shape. What we see here is a preview of the offset value, which right now is set to 1-point-something points. So I'm going to go ahead and set mine to 1.5. And following that, we have the join fields, which allows us to edit the angles of the newly created offset paths. So the first option is the miter option, which creates sharp corners. The second option is the round join, which creates a rounded corner. And the third option is the bevel join, which creates a flat corner. So in my case, I will keep the default option, the round join, and then I would tap to create an offset path. And then inside the style inspector, I do have a fill, but I also need to have a stroke color. So I would toggle on the visibility of the stroke. And looking at the stroke width, right now this is set to 1 point, and that works very well for me. And now we are ready to go to the next step and create additional offset paths. The offset tool inside Vectornado, as I mentioned earlier, creates a duplicate of the original shape. So in this case, I will only target the offset paths inside the layers panel to create additional offsets, which means I will tap on this curve and then swipe to the right, keep swiping to the right, and select the rest of the offset paths. With this path selected, I will tap on the path inspector, and all the way at the bottom, I will tap offset path. For the offset value here, I'm just going to tap and set mine to 1.8 points. I will keep the rest as is, and then tap to create offset path. Let me go ahead and change the fill color to perhaps this red color and the stroke to this blue color. This again, a very personal choice. All right, great. Things look fantastic. Now, what else can we do? This time around, I will go ahead and target all the original shapes inside the layers panel, the ones without an offset value, which means I would target this curve and then swipe to the right and then keep swiping for the ones that they have no offset value. With this shape selected, I'm going to go ahead and combine those shapes into one, and I'm going to do this inside the tab inspector by using the combine boolean operation. And now we have one shape, as we can see here inside the layers panel. And with that shape here, what I'm going to do is apply a texture uniformly across the whole group of letters, which means I would tap on the library tab, and all the way at the bottom of the options, I would tap on the photos to access the camera roll, and then tap on this transparent PNG and apply this to the shape. Now, right now, as you can see, this gets applied everywhere. So the first thing I'm going to do is just rename this to texture. There we go. And then I'm just going to tap and hold and bring this under the curve, and then tap to select this one, and then swipe to the right and select both of these. And then inside looking here at the quick actions bar, just going to use the mask icon like so. And this gets masked to the group of letters. Now, the only thing I'm going to change here is the fill color to another color of my choice, something a bit lighter. And here's an idea using the offset path tool inside VectorNator.